Welcome to a fascinating journey where technology meets creativity. In recent years, artificial neural networks have moved from being a niche concept to a powerful tool that's reshaping how we think about literature. Today, computers don't just analyze poetry, they can generate it. But what does this mean for the world of literature? As AI poems flood the internet, scholars and readers alike are left wondering, how should we interpret these machine-generated works? Are they just digital curiosities, or do they offer real insights into the art of poetry? In this video, we'll explore the evolution of computer-generated poetry, from early rule-based experiments to today's sophisticated neural networks, and discover how this technology is becoming an essential part of digital humanities. Let's rewind to the origins of computer poetry. In the late 1950s and early 1960s, pioneers like Theo Lutz and Nanny Bjelstrini used computers to randomly combine words, creating what they called stochastic texts. These early experiments relied on randomness and simple rules, producing lines that look poetic but often lack deeper meaning. Fast forward to today, and the landscape has changed dramatically. Modern artificial neural networks can learn from vast collections of poetry, capturing not just vocabulary, but also style, rhythm, and even subtle wordplay. The shift from rule-based programming to machine learning means that computers no longer need explicit instructions for every scenario. They can discover patterns on their own. As a result, AI-generated poems now echo the stylistic essence of entire literary traditions, opening up new ways to study and appreciate poetry. Now let's dive into the concept of neural reading. Unlike traditional distant reading, which relies on quantitative analysis of large corpora, neural reading invites us to closely interpret texts generated by AI models trained on massive poetic datasets. These machine-generated poems act as a digital echo chamber, reflecting the stylistic features of entire genres or periods. For example, when a neural network is trained on Russian hexameters or the works of Friedrich Hölderlin, it produces new verses that mimic the original's rhythm, vocabulary, and even creative quirks. While these poems may lack coherent narrative, they offer a concentrated glimpse into the stylistic DNA of their sources. By reading and analyzing these outputs, scholars gain fresh perspectives on literary style, authorship, and the evolving relationship between humans and machines in the arts. As we look ahead, the integration of neural networks into literary studies promises to transform how we understand and engage with poetry. AI-generated texts are not just playful experiments, they're powerful tools for exploring the nuances of style, language, and creativity across vast literary landscapes. By combining close reading of neural poetry with traditional analysis, researchers can uncover patterns and stylistic features that might otherwise go unnoticed. This approach doesn't replace human interpretation. Instead, it expands our toolkit, allowing us to ask new questions and see literature from fresh angles. As machines become collaborators in the creation and study of art, the boundaries between author, reader, and technology continue to blur, ushering in a new era of digital creativity and scholarly discovery.